Hi, I'm Kevin.
And I'm Kenny.
Basketball?
Basketball.
Honestly, I'm so surprised we're good enough to do a basketball show. I don't even have a joke ready. But we do have this pretty cool Penn State basketball snow globe.
Snow globe? Does that count as a joke?
Let's get to the show. Offensively in basketball, you don't really run a set play every time you come down the court. Instead, you kind of have an offensive concept that you can do different things out of. However, that doesn't mean that you never run a set play. A lot of times out of timeouts, coaches like to call a set play, and another time they really like to run a set play is out of the tip-off on the first play of the game, and that's exactly what Penn State does here. You can see that they're still introducing the starters. We're only about 5 seconds into the game, and Penn State is about to run a fantastic opening play that was very well designed. The goal of this play is basically to get Mike Watkins' defender right here distracted so that they can do a back screen on him and give Watkins an alley-oop. How do they do that? The first thing they do is have Mike Watkins set an on-the-ball screen. So Miles Dredd is going to dribble towards the middle of the court off of the screen, and because the most important player on the basketball court is the one with the ball, Mike Watkins' defender has to respect him and pay attention to him. The next thing Penn State's going to do... The next thing Penn State's going to do is pass the ball to the other side of the court. Since this defender already has to pay attention to Miles Dredd, it's going to come naturally that his eyes are going to follow the ball to the other side of the court. And that's where Penn State gets sneaky. Lamar Stevens is going to come up behind him and set a back pick, and Dawkins is going to run to the hoop, and they're going to throw an alley-oop to him. And by the time this defender realizes what's going on, it's already too late, and Penn State gets an easy 2 points to start the game. So here comes Watkins to set the pick. Throw it over. There's the back screen. Alley-oop. Great play design. Now, you might think that playing man-to-man defense in basketball means all you have to do is stick with your man and don't let him score. But that's actually not true at all. The best man-to-man defenses don't play their man individually, but it's five defenders playing as one unit. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, this play is a perfect example of Penn State's defense playing as a single unit as opposed to five people guarding their players individually. The Maryland point guard is going to dribble over to the right side of the court, and both of these Penn State defenders are going to go over to double team trying to trap him. Now, that's going to leave this player open. So you might think, okay, all the point guard has to do is loft an easy pass over their heads to the open player, and they continue to play. And that's exactly what would happen if Penn State's defense wasn't playing as a single unit. Now, Isaiah Brockington is all the way over here, and his man's in the corner. So if he's just sticking to his man and not worrying about anything else, he would stay right here. But what I mean by playing as one unit is when he sees this double team over here, what he's going to do is going to rotate over to guard this player. And if you can rotate over fast enough, you might be able to, well, you'll see what happens. So now watch Brockington. If he's just focused on his man, he would never try and rotate over, and the fall-in would never happen. Drop the hammer! Penn State's good this year, I'm telling you, they're good. Now this is going to sound crazy, but these two things are both true. The refs were very favorable to Penn State this entire game, and also, Penn State did not shoot a single free throw until about 5 minutes left in the game. Now, how could the refs be favorable to them despite that being true? Well, here's one example. This is kind of hard to see, but after a rebound, the Maryland player is trying to pass out. Except he can't pass the ball because Wheeler literally is grabbing his arm. You can kind of see it there. He doesn't have the ball. He has his arm. So when the guy's trying to pass, he physically can't because his arm is being held and he travels. Does the ref call the foul? No, the ref calls the freaking travel. Can you believe that? I mean, yeah, he traveled. He traveled because he was getting mugged. And who got the call? We got the call? We never get the call. How'd we get the call? Let's watch it in real time. Okay, watch number two by Maryland here. He gets the rebound, and then he gets fouled slightly by Brockington, and then he pretty much gets his arm ripped off by Wheeler. There is no call until the travel, which is what they call. It was glorious. Two right there. Here comes the arm rip. And they called the travel. They never called the travel. I can't believe it. But wait, there's more. Okay, this one's my favorite. You have this little Maryland guy dribbling into the paint with the giant that is Mike Walken standing right in front of him. So you know what you do in that situation? You pump fake. And that's exactly what he does. He pump fakes and he gets Mike Watkins to jump into the air and he literally jumps right on top of him. That's a foul every single time. You can't literally jump up and then land on the guy. That's a foul. Do the refs call it? No. He gets up some sort of weird shot the best he could because he's getting mugged by, again, the giant that is Mike Watkins, and they don't call a foul. But you know what they do call a foul on? This Maryland giant here, number 25. All he does is jump up to grab the rebound, and he gets a foul called on him for being tall. Because Jamari Wheeler here, the smallest guy in the court, just happens to kind of waddle his way down here and jump at the same time. Literally, all he does is just jump up and grab the ball, but because Wheeler's so much smaller than him, it kind of looks like he's jumping over his back, when in reality, he's not doing that at all. He's just jumping up to grab the board, but they call over the back on the Maryland center when it's really the Penn State center that mugged the shooter. I'm going to rewind it a little bit and show it to you, but it is hilarious. All right, we got it coming to you in slow motion. Here's the pump fake. Jumps right on top of him. That's got to be a foul. And look, all he does is just jump. He just jumps straight up over Wheeler. And they called a foul. They called a foul on Maryland.
Did you ever wonder what it would look like if you tried to shoot a three-point basket? Well,
that concludes our first ever basketball show. I hope you enjoyed it.
But one last thing before we go. Who's the coach of Maryland's basketball team?
It's Mark Turgeon. Oh, wait, no. Oh, no. No, 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 no.
What do you call a Maryland basketball coach in the Bryce Jordan Center?
I don't know. What?
He's Mark Laid a Turd Again.
Oh, damn it, Kenny!